It's certainly with great joy that we come together to this place in the presence of our wonderful Savior to join together Alan and Beth at Holy Natural. On behalf of Alan and Beth, I want to thank you for joining us. You came at your invitation, and your presence symbolizes your love for them as well as your support for the future together. As their loved ones, the most important contribution you can make to this marriage is to pray for them with warmth and consistency. Therefore, let us seek the Lord's blessing on this solemn occasion. Our most gracious Father, come today, our hearts filled with joy and thanksgiving for our death. We give you thanks for the sincerity we see in their lives, for the love which they have for you and for each other. We pray that Alan and Beth might always keep you at the center of this relationship, in their home, in their very lives. Father, bless them with your strength now as they verbalize their commitment to you and to each other. May these commitments bring glory to their Savior. Extremely difficult time trying to fill the void in your life, asking for your wife and your enemies. It is once again your turn, you found the strength to go on. As you began to grow spiritually, God saw fit to bring Beth into your life. She has been an encouragement to you on your spiritual journey. Friendship has blossomed to the point that tonight we are gathered here to unite your lives together, to continue this journey together. Beth, I haven't known you this long. You too have been through significant circumstances. God has seen fit to bring Alan into your life to be an encouragement. So you two, as you ignite your lives, will become complete together. No longer two people, but one body that you will share for however many years of to think of marriage as thoughts of love. Yet today there are many misconceptions of love. So we need to qualify what love is. This love upon which marriage is built. Infatuation, misnamed love, is not enough. Lust, which is misrepresented as love, is an enemy of marriage. A clear picture of love, the love necessary for a lifelong venture, is given to us in 1 Corinthians 13. Jealous or boastful, it does not demand its own way, it is not irritable, it keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, lead to her in all things the true and faithful husband, so long as you are shall be. Do you surprise? Beth, in taking Alan to be your lawful husband, before God and these witnesses present here tonight, you must promise to love him, to honor, cherish him, and me and all others to be known to him, to be to him all things. Second only to your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Each time these rings, when you touch these rings, they remind you of the sacredness of your relationship with God. How would you take this ring? Place it on the ring finger of Beth's left hand while holding it. Signifies that they are no longer two but one in the Lord Jesus Christ. As much as Alan and Beth have exchanged their vows, and sealed these vows, giving them rings, the presence of God in this room. Are you committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ? I declare my husband and wife. But therefore, God has joined together. Father, as we come before you today, we are so thankful. Thankful for what you have been doing in our lives. Father, for